This is the question at hand. This is the question at hand. I think end of the day, we have been robbed very low. And this is not small 2 million, 3 million. This is running into billions now. Billions of plunder. And therefore, I think the time has come for us to do something about this. Now, back faith, talking about back faith. The issue that Dr. Subra had raised, that just 2 days before the end of the concession period, I mean, not the concession, 2 days before the offer, so we come back with the offer, the state government said, the federal government said they will go direct negotiations. But I just want to raise one important issue about what is this notion of restructuring about. If you look at the water services industry side, it is quite clear that the licensee must take over lock, stock, and barrel. That means every component of it must be taken over. And if you look at the letters that the minister has written to the state government of Selangor, that means you take over the concessionaire. That means you buy the assets, you do what you have to do to take over the business. That is the meaning of restructuring. However, when the government made its offer, and based on that, as Dr. Subra said just now, there was a calculation for values, asset values, as well as a fair and reasonable return, which he explained just now. So based on that, we got a $5.7 billion figure. But the government changed the terms of restructuring, or changed the question by saying restructuring, as we understand it, and the federal government understands it, is just the assets, but not the concession. And this happened but just a few weeks ago, just as we approached towards March 31st. Now clearly this shows a lot of bad faith is involved. Now end of the day, the state government, Selangor is very clear, and that is, water is a fundamental human right. Water is a fundamental human right, and the governments have a responsibility in realizing their right. In realizing that right. And that is what the state government is pushing. And it is saying, that's what Dr. Subra said earlier, if today Selangor takes over water, tomorrow the direct charges will come down by 10%. So I think the point basically here is that one, we can provide it additionally, and the Penang is a good example. I actually did a research on a small booklet on Penang. I spent some time looking and talking to engineers, talking to workers, talking to all the different structures in Penang, wherever that road. And I can tell you, Penang's water is 22 cents per cubic meter. 22 for the first 20 cubic meters of water. It is one of the cheapest tariffs in 60 of the biggest cities in the world. In the world. And in 2004, 2005, 2000, after 2006, 2007, their minimum profit is 50 million ringgit, and they have cash of 230 million ringgit available to them. And on top of that, their non-revenue water is between 80 and 20% of world record. A world record. So why can't we learn from them? And we have economics of scale, we're a bigger state. And we have water in our state. Penang doesn't have water, it comes from Urumuda River. So if they can do a great job, we can do a better job. So therefore, my friend, what is being organized in front of us is plunder. It's plunder. And therefore, we have to fight back. And we don't have much time to fight back anymore. Because by end of March 31st, the government will announce that they are going to hand over what management of water in Selangor to Shabazz. Now, this actually means, of course, that all of us know that the government actually is not supporting efficient provider of water, but really saying, I'm going to support my colony. And this is what is happening right now. And I think we have to stop here. We have to stop them from doing that. Otherwise, we are going to fund UMNO, and most importantly, at least for my purposes, we are going to have a highly inefficient and a public utility that is not transparent, that really doesn't care what you think or what I think. Because in spite of all the criticism that has come out, nothing can touch that. So just like what we did on March 8th, what you did on March 8th, time has come to rise up and be counted and to fight back. I'll stop here. Thank you very much.
everybody has said.